What were the highlights and lowlights of police force and police work? Well, it's never the same. Every day is something different. Kind of like wrestling. Every day is something different. I remember when I got sworn in, holding my hand up and holding the badge and swearing, and that was a highlight, getting picked. And then going through the 16-week field training program, and then passing that and sending me up to the Carson City to go through police academy. I graduated number one in police academy, which was a highlight. Came back down and started police work. There's some funny stories and there's some sad stories. One story comes to mind right off the bat. We responded to a trailer, a mobile home fire. And we get there and it's kind of like a mobile home burning next to a house. And questioning the people there, come to find out that the lady who lived in the mobile home was kind of mentally challenged. And the family lived right next door. So they had her live in that mobile home. And what had happened is, I guess she thought there was demons in her couch. So she wanted to get the demons out of her couch and she lit it on fire. Well, the mobile home kind of just, once it starts, it goes real quick. So an arson investigator showed up there and to judge, is this arson and stuff like that. Well, didn't really qualify as arson because she burnt her own home. It was in the middle of the desert, didn't harm anything else, nothing else was in danger. But this woman took offense to the investigator being there and she picked up a rock and threw it at him and hit him with the rock and then ran into the family's house. Well, he was talking to us and we were deciding what could we do, and you know, she's mentally challenged and it's been documented. We were talking to one of the family members, and as we're talking, the lady came out of the house with a wooden doily, the kind you hang your clothes on in the closet. She came out with that, and she had like a terry cloth dress on, and she was holding that up going, she was gonna hit us, gonna hit anybody. I was like, oh my gosh. And by then, a crowd had formed, the news was there, and I'm like, uh-oh. So the arson investigator skedaddled, that's the way he was, and me and my partner were there. She was coming after us with a stick, and I'm like, oh my goodness. Can't draw a gun, can't draw a nightstick, you know, and can't use mace. I didn't have any mace. So I'm thinking, oh my gosh, and we're backing up. As I back up, I trip off the fire hose. Doink! And I look down, and I looked at my partner, I said, I got an idea. So I picked up the fire hose, and it's like a gun, you know, it has a nozzle on top, and I went, picked it up, and I said, take another step, and I'm gonna blast you. And she stopped and looked at me, my partner looked at me, and I went, I grabbed the top of the nozzle, and I said, I mean it. She looked, she had a look in her eye like, you're not going to, and then she looked at me, look, and she started to walk forward again. Oh, that was it. I opened up on her, poof, and I hit her with this 2-inch hose, and she got all that, and boom, down she went. That terry cloth dress kind of went, it sucked to her like a sponge. And I hit her with a lot of water. And she was screaming and screaming. I can't say what she was screaming here, but she was on the ground screaming. And then I turned off the hose and I held it under my arm and I was like, aha. And then she got up. I think she was a little madder than the first time. She got up all wet, muddy, and grabbed the stick again. And she was gonna hit me with it again. I said, don't do it. I'm warning you. And she walked forward and I hit her again. Well, at that time, the family had ran in the house and I doused her again. She was on the ground screaming, shut the hose off. Here comes the family, a whole bunch of them. They have rope. They tied the lady up, picked her up and hoisted her in the house. So it was kind of like real funny because I got the job done. Nobody got hurt. Nobody went to jail. And the situation was squashed. So I that was kind of a funny part of my career. I remember that. It was kind of hilarious. Instead of using violence, I used a water hose.